Hey guys, it's Lance at Mac Sound Solutions. Today I'm here with Joe DeGiorgi, owner of Headline Studios in Mamaroneck, New York.
Yes.
We've streamed this up several times before this.
Well done, McVicker.
Anyway, today we are going to operate on his Mac Pro. He has a 2010 2.4 gigahertz 8 core.
Yes.
Which we are going to be upgrading to a 12 core with 5680s 3.33 gigahertz. And that should really give him a nice boost for his Pro Tools setup. So let's get to the surgery right away. And this should be very easy compared to my other two videos where I'm doing it on a 2009 Mac Pro with my fingers crossed, of course, because I've never upgraded a 2010. But from what I understand, this should be a lot easier than upgrading a 2009 because the integrated heat caps are on the chips already, so there's no difference in CPU size when you're inserting the CPUs. They are the same, and basically they're just faster. So we should be able to pull off the heat sinks, clean off the old CPUs, take them out of there, put in the new CPUs, clean off the heat sinks, put them back on, boot it up, and Bob's your uncle. Fingers crossed. We'll see you in a minute.
It is a dream, this processor, how easily it comes out.
Yeah. Silver, silver. RAM you got there.
24 gigs.
24 gigs. Out comes the processor tray. So you can maybe notate this, because I'm going to count how many unscrews it takes before we get the click out of this, because it gives us a ballpark number of how many screws to tighten down. The whole pressure on top of the CPU is so important. Like if you do it too much, you can crush the pins under the processor and then you're up shit's creek and you need to buy another one of these boards.
Where's my alcohol?
Okay, I'm in.
With the white thing facing you.
One. Two, three, four, five, six.
Because they're all roundabout in the 7.5 to 8.5.
Processor, see, yours has this thing that holds the processor down. That's why it was harder to get it off, because when I pull this, you see this whole mechanism. Yeah. When I pull this off on mine, the processor just sticks to this. It doesn't have a nice clamp to hold it down. Okay, well, good. I'm glad it came off. I don't know why it was being difficult on the...
I'll hold it over here if you want.
Yeah, we can just put it here. We got to clean that whole surface off. Down, out. How does this gizmo work? Oh boy. Watch. There it is. And what happened to me on the last one?
Mm-hmm.
The processors that I got came with a bunch of gook on the side, and somehow that gook landed between that and this on my second CPU.
And on the other side of that, all those little connectors are...
Touch all those pins.
Precisely, or is it a general?
No, it's precise. They have to be touching each little pin, and if one of those is bent, you're in big trouble. In fact, a guy who just tried to do this upgrade on his 2009, he bumped this or something, and he bent a pin, and then he tried to bend the pin back, and it snapped off. You're screwed. Dude, you're screwed.
Okay.
awful lot easier. It's funny, you're not seeing any Loctite. These actually look slightly different than mine somehow. Yeah, there's no Loctite. Instead, they have these little locking washer things on them. Interesting. Slightly different scenario. Have some weight to them. Gold, there's gold in them hills.
And this has a zero shift.
Don't touch it with your stinky finger. I just cleaned it off of all the oils. What are you doing? You ruined it. You killed it.
That has no shift, right? When that falls in there, it's...
Yeah, because there's two little nooks that it has to be in. Do this.
You sure she's clean, right?
We'll find out soon enough. See, this adds the pressure right here. You're already clamping down the CPU.
Which means we don't know if this is the right pressure. Right?
What's that?
Like when you clamp that down, it's clamping down a different height.
That's scary. That has to be... No, it's the same height. There's no change in height here. It's just that little nook has to be underneath.
Right. Did you put the goop on it?
No, you put it on after.
Oh, you put it on the top?
Yeah. Yikes. That really adds a lot of pressure. Whoa.
Do you feel good about this? Are you?
Yeah. So far. that part scares me a little because you're clamping down pressure onto the thing, you know, big time.
And yours, the pressure is all from the top.
It's all from that happening, yeah.
Well, it is a complete design change, so.
Well, not really. It's not supposed to be that different. But yeah, it is different. That went in very easily. Yes, those posts are where they're supposed to be. Much better than the other time I did it. And goopy. See these posts?
Yeah.
On mine, the posts are on the logic board. These just screw into the logic board. Whereas the posts are sticking out in mine.
Well, I think those posts are traveling through to the base unit.
But they're just different. The posts are on the logic board on mine, and the posts are on your heat sinks.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
I have no comment. I only have anxiety.
One, two,
looks?
Let's just go with four turns on each, and then we'll come around again. Four.
Okay.
Yeah. That is better. So what was our total turns again? I want to go one turn under the total.
All right, so number one was 7.5.
He's got that worried look.
Dr. McVicker, save me!
All right, everybody. This did not go as smoothly as I had expected. First time I'm doing a 2010. The heat sinks are still hard to get on. The posts are in a different location. It's almost trickier in its own way. Fingers crossed. We went one turn less than it took to take them off. And we had a little issue with heatsink B being level.
That was the big one, right?
Yeah.
That's what has you worried.
I'll allow you to do the
honors. Oh, really?
Yes.
Liability.
Plugged in. I know it's not plugged in yet. That always helps.
Scared me! Thought it was dead!
That's good.
Not yet. We need the bing.
Fire extinguisher.
Okay, it's not flashing.
Yes! That's a big plus.
Lance literally just lost 4 pounds.
She boots! That's also a plus.
Okay.
The fans are behaving. That's another plus.
Oh. Non-plus.
What do you mean non-plus? Oh. That's not good.
All right, so
doing it again. Can we get a different monitor, please? Because
I don't have it.
So here's our Geekbench score. Let me just focus on that a little better. There's our Geekbench score. Originally, Joe had his single is 2054. Now his single is 2687. His multi score was 15885. Now almost. Well, it is double the amount, 30,219, from 8 cores to 12 cores. Dr. McVicker.
Dr. McVicker, the man. That is pretty deep what you just did. That's risky, scary stuff right there.
Yeah, it is a little risky, scary.
I would never do that. I don't have your guts. I have no guts when it comes to that.
So another happy customer.
Man, right there. Dr. McVicker. No idea.
I'm getting paid with some Indian food. I'm not really a big fan of Indian food, by the way, but I will give it a go.
Well, we have other.
Okay.
We have other cuisine.
But if you really recommend it's a great experience and there's beer included, then.
There's beer included. 2017. I do not want to mess around with that.
Don't walk in front of the lens for a second. Just do a little scanner of the room.
Messy.
Yeah, I'm trying to avoid some of the mess, but.
Oh, this is definitely fast.
Here we are.
Another happy customer.
It's definitely faster. The Pro Tools session.
Pro Tools is launching quick. Here we are at Headline Studios. Post-processor install.
We'll boot a full multi-track session. Playback engine. So I'm going to take this all the way to 11 processors, correct? So this is a demo of the upgrade to Ozone. This is Ozone 7, which I'm demonstrating for 10 days. And this, I forget what it's called, algorithm? This algorithm for processing and limiting is very CPU heavy and could not open in the old setup, but in this setup.
Let's be clear what the old setup was. He's actually talking about his older processor.
If you were to open the previous version of this, these three options were in there. You could open this one. You could open this one, but you could not open the third one. This one uses even more CPU processor than this, and it's opening just fine.
All right. Signing off at Headline Studios, Mamaroneck, New York. Give Joe a call. He's a great engineer. And... yeah.
All right.
Nice studio, Joe.
Thanks.
Hi, guys. It's Lance from Mac Sound Solutions. And today, we're going to be installing new processors.
You should start off.
Why?
Because I'm sitting here staring at my freaking iPhone looking at text.
Whatever. Look at the camera lens. All right. Hey, guys. This is Lance from Mac Sound Solutions. And today, I am here with my buddy Joe DeGiorgi at his recording studio, Headline Sound, in Mamaroneck, New York. Did I blow it again? Headline Studios.
Headline Studios. Can I get a copy of the preamble?
Yeah, well, I might use some of it.